One, two. That was a bit spasticated. I think we
That
should
was
do it again.
spasticated. Do it again.
All right.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to an extra Jarcast. Don't know what we're going to call it. I mean, I've already called it Jarcast, so I guess that's decided. But we are joined by the clown, as some of you may know him.
Clown. Well, just call it that. Just call it clown. That's it.
We're joined by clown.
That's good enough.
Clown.
Hello, how are you doing? Glad to be on.
Yes,
we've been talking. We've been talking about me coming on for the last how long, Ruben? Like,
I think
two,
might,
3 months.
Yeah,
and you've only just
four.
Figured out how to record a Skype conversation. So, congratulations there.
Well,
I reckon.
Because we thought we'd need to record. Some one person would record that. You know what? There's coming to them. What's coming to them? As
right.
opposed to just everybody recording their audio and sending it to somebody.
I've got a question for you, clown.
Okay.
A question.
Oh, we're already jumping.
Here we go.
Why?
Yeah.
Why on earth do you want to be on the Jar Media podcast?
I like the podcast. It's good.
Do
I
you?
Watch it. Yeah.
I mean,
no, you
good.
Don't. I fuck it. I'm
I think,
calling.
No, it's true. I'm not.
You're
I'm
just
not lying.
Humoring us.
To be honest, like this was the first, other than the Drunken Peasants, which I don't enjoy. To be honest,
mm-hmm.
the Jarcast was actually the first kind of podcast for YouTube that I listened to. So
shut up.
That's why. Yeah. Well, you name a few other podcasts on YouTube run by YouTubers. I can't think of any.
There's the Bated. Excellent Garden podcast.
No, okay, but the first one around your time, like before you.
I noticed actually, it's weird. Okay, it sounds kind of dicky, but I noticed lots of podcasts started appearing after the Jarcast existed. Just lots of them, just little ones, just appearing.
We invented podcasts, everybody. Ruben
we
said on the Jar Media podcast.
No,
we
invented
podcasts.
That's right. But no, I just noticed groups of small YouTubers doing the same thing as we did.
Now,
but
was
like,
it? Was it? Was it? Are you taking credit for this, or is Baited
no.
taking credit for this?
Because
I think
Baited
was created, and then a lot of podcasts were created after Baited. Like, we were definitely after
but I just
you.
I just
like, you
remembered before Baited. I remember just seeing like, hey, there's a podcast.
It is thanks
hey,
to
we
Baited,
did this
though.
First. We did this first. You fuckers. We did
we
it first.
Let's make it clear though, we didn't invent podcasts.
We invented podcasts.
The reason I've always wanted a podcast because for years and years and years I've been obsessed with them. Like, I would listen to, like, 5 or 6 while I was doing
I remember
things.
One of the ones I listened to when I was younger was the Rooster Teeth podcast, but I quickly got fed up with it because I realized I don't really like any of you that much. You heard it here first, people. Don't dislike them, just didn't really care to listen to them for 2 hours.
So did you start listening to this podcast because it was simply talking about YouTube-type things?
Absolutely,
I
wanted a podcast to listen to that was talking about YouTube. Exactly that. And to be honest with you, I had never listened to a podcast properly before. Like, I'd heard ones here and there. Obviously, I used to listen to the Ricky Gervais podcast a lot.
Mm.
I don't think it really does. It really count as a podcast? Well, I guess it does. But it's like
it's got
a very, very
value.
different podcast to everything else that was out there at the time.
Yeah, for sure.
So obviously, I was listening to that. But with that as an exception, I don't think anything else. Not really.
That's wild because, like, this podcast, man.
The way I look at it, I'm always like, wow, what a fucking piece of shit. Why would anyone listen to this for an hour at a time? Why?
Right.
Why would you do this?
I was kind of thinking that with a Baited podcast, but for some reason,
I did listen
everyone's
to a Baited.
To it.
I did
I've
listen,
listened
to
every
episode.
Episode
1. I listened to episode 1.
Yeah.
And I got to say, it was an interesting experience.
It's not bad. It's pretty good.
Yeah.
It's a lot
it's
of fun
good.
To do.
It's
and
extremely
people,
entertaining.
Yeah.
It's entertaining.
It's just, I just love the dynamic of it, because I remember I was wondering, like, okay, Colossal and Keem are getting on for about 20 minutes. All right, this is going okay. And then it was you and him shitting on your channel and Tommy screaming, defending your channel.
I mean, that's pretty much Baited in a nutshell, really.
And that was it.
Though recently it has been, like, kind of shitting on Grade and Leafy and then... Mm. Yeah, me defending them and then me dick sucking them. But yeah,
somebody,
that's pretty much it.
No.
That's what it's trying.
What makes it work is the contrast, though. Because normally podcasts are like a group of friends who
a
come
group,
together
yeah,
and they're talking
buddies.
About something they all, you know,
exactly.
share, the interests they share. But this is what makes it entertaining is the fact that nearly everything that comes up, at least two of you will disagree on something. So there's
yes.
always some
What I do find
kind of
interesting
discussion.
Is the way it was like even formed. It was just... Keemstar, you were probably on Keem's block list for fucking ages.
Oh, I've been blocked by Keemstar a total of 9 times in a row, which is quite, which I believe is the record, but perhaps not now.
And now you have a podcast together.
I know, it's a bit crazy to think of, really, but In fairness to Keem, that's what he wanted. He wanted people that two people that disagreed with him. And Tommy and I, at the time, were two people who were very vocal against Keemstar. And that's why he had us on, really.
Really,
that's
Tommy why he chose was. Us.
Tommy, yeah, he had a huge, huge argument with Keemstar on his own show about another Tommy, Tommy NC, who is the guy that Leafy made a video about who has autism. And Tommy was defending, because Keemstar was defending Leafy at the time because they were friends. Mm-hmm. And so therefore Tommy went against Keem because he was defending Leafy for it.
Oh,
and this
right.
is how this all happened. And now, the if you think about it, it's just a complete fucking mess because now Keemstar and Leafy are not friends. Keemstar is attacking Leafy. And no, it's just very, very confusing. I just can't even explain it.
Yeah.
I don't know. Yeah, but Alex is right, right? It's that's the thing. It's a great dynamic. Like Keemstar and I disagree on just about everything. Like, we're two very, very different people. And Tommy is there as a mediatory to just laugh like a fucking jackal while all this shit is going
laugh,
on.
His laugh that's why is it works. Something
it's
else.
Perfect, yeah.
It is something else.
I actually
yeah.
have a question here from Zaptai of all people asking,
oh, right, yeah.
do you regret agreeing to the beta podcast? Because you got a lot of shit for it when you first announced it. I remember.
I did, and I think a lot of that shit that I got was unfounded.
Oh, for sure.
Which has been proved,
because the Keemstar shit was at, like, maybe at its peak at that point.
Right.
And it was all just jumping on you because just mentioning the name together with yours and that you're going to work
with
him.
Right, just mere association with DJ Keemstar, yeah, that's what happened.
Yeah, yeah.
But I don't think anybody faults me for it now. And
no. If anything, it's helped you, right?
Exactly.
Yeah.
And I thought back then, like, I was doing it for entertainment purposes, to entertain myself mostly, and also to entertain others and whatever. But I think now it's become, people actually want the beta podcast, me to do the beta podcast. Whereas back then they didn't want me to do it. So was it a mistake to do? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. I think it was a great move, a great decision. And I think a lot of people, most people see it that way.
Oh, for sure, yeah. It has worked out really well for you in the end.
Yeah.
100%.
I love it. As long as I don't lose my mind, I think we should be good.
Yeah, what is it like having to work with Keem after... you have to go back to him every week or
It's not the easiest thing in the world, I'll be honest with you. Like, working with Keemstar is not easy at all. He's not an easy person to get on with in general. And when I started the podcast, me and Keemstar were not friends at all. Like, we were not friends at all. But I would actually say now, despite everything, I think we've become friends in a way.
It does seem that way when I see you interact on Twitter. I think those two are, I think they're friends, like, deep down.
I think we are now. I think there's no argument against it. Like, I know people say, oh, Colossal will never, ever become friends with Keemstar. No, I think we have. I think you speak to someone every day, and we do speak almost every day. Not every day, but almost every day. You speak to someone for that long. And I also want to say, like, Keemstar, the guy you see on Twitter, the guy you see on Dramlet, is very different once you actually get to know him. Like, I know that's very easy to say.
Yeah.
But he really is. And obviously, Keemstar has done a lot for me. And I do consider him a friend. Like, I think he's a very loyal person. And he's got my back. Everything against him, you know. Keemstar's a bastard, let's face it. He's a fucking bastard. But... every person, every bastard has some good qualities.
Yeah,
and
that is actually
Keemstar
it. I've always tried to work
qualities.
Out what it is because I defend Keemstar quite regularly, but then I'm also like, God, you're a fucking cunt at the same time. And bastard is the perfect word.
Oh, he's a cunt, no doubt about
bastard
it.
Bastard is the word because it implies, oh yeah, they're a bastard, but it implies they're likable as well.
Yeah.
Right. He is. At the end of the day, he's a very entertaining bastard. And that's it. That's all it is to it. Whether you agree with him, don't agree with him on every point because often, like, his points are just a bit fucked.
Yeah.
But, like, he's an entertaining
guy. The good thing about
Baited
is that he actually makes a bunch of really well-thought-out points.
He does.
If Keemstar wasn't saying, more people would take seriously, but the fact he's saying it kind of undermines it. But if you take that away from it, he actually is making some pretty good points here and there.
He's a smart guy, you know, he's a smart guy. People think he's stupid. The people who think Keemstar is stupid are pretty stupid. He's not stupid.
It's strange. It's like, because I say, oh, Keem, you're such a fucking idiot. Like, when he says things that are just like, come on, Keemstar, if you didn't say that so abrasively, people would value it a little more.
Yeah.
Come on, fucking prick, think. Think.
Right, exactly. And I was thinking that at the time, so I don't blame anyone for thinking that as well. But I think the problem is, people equate stupidity with impulsivity. And Keemstar, while not stupid, is incredibly, incredibly impulsive. Doesn't think before he actually does something.
Yeah.
That's always been his fucking problem. You know, other than being, you know, narcissistic and the rest of it. So, yeah.
So let's bring it back to you, Clown.
Okay.
I want to know, you've been on YouTube for a while now, right? But not under the whole clown thing. You did like trolling shit or something?
I did. Yeah, I did. Yeah.
You did. How long did you do that for?
I want to say a year.
A year?
Yeah.
And well, did it get any attention? Were you?
No.
No.
Not
no.
at all. I think at the height, well, up until the beginning of this year, January, I was on 5,000 subscribers. So. Mm.
Yeah.
So no is the answer to that. I think my most viewed video, which was a trolling video, was about 30,000 views, I think.
Oh, fuck yeah.
So what did you troll? Like Call of Duty kids or something? What was it?
I was in a Call of Duty chat room or whatever, or in a game, and I just shit talk other players, and that pretty much was it.
Really? I found that really interesting. Like if I had to pin any type of content to you, I never would have guessed that.
Well, I don't know.
I think it was because
anything.
Of the voice, wasn't it? It's like you don't expect to hear my voice in a Call of Duty lobby or whatever. So I think that's what made it work. I don't even. The whole thing of it is, I don't even like Call of Duty. I fucking hate that game. I hate the whole series. I don't like first-person shooters in general. But I bought it in the first place because it was the best game at the time to shit talk players. The game where most players were active, most players were speaking. Yeah. That's the only reason I played it. If there was another game available where a lot of players were speaking, I would have chosen that game.
So what made you drop that and do the whole Colossal thing?
I want to say because half of it wasn't working for me.
Yeah.
The trolling videos. But
the
also,
game,
I was friends with Pyrocynical. I've been friends with him for 2 years. And he started doing these commentary videos. I was like, they're pretty good. I can do better than that, I reckon.
Ooh.
That's what I was thinking at the time.
Ooh.
Well, I mean, even Pyrocynical said to me, like, I think you'd be good at this. Like, you've got the perfect voice for it or whatever. And I was like, I'll give it a go. And so I made that Bashiverse video. That was the first commentary I made. And like, it did really well. And I was like, well, shit, I actually enjoyed doing this as well. So I just kept on fucking doing it. And here I am.
A Colossal video I watched was the Amazing Atheist video.
Didn't I recommend it, Ruben?
Yeah, you did. You told me to watch it, and it was
I think it was either. Yeah. Which one did you make first? Was it the
Bashiverse was the first commentary I made.
Because I've seen all your videos. It was one of those ones. It was very early on.
You've seen all your videos. He's your biggest fan.
Mm.
Biggest fan.
For sure.
I can't even remember how I found you.
You just kind of cropped up, and then you're everywhere. Just in a space of months, now you're like just everywhere.
It's kind of crazy, really, to think about. But that, I guess that just happens. Like, it's very much a snowball effect, isn't it? Like, once
you actually
get to a certain point, like, it just becomes more and more and more and more and more. The snowball keeps rolling down the fucking hill until it's like, you know, a fucking boulder.
You're just lucky, the relative short amount of time, considering. Like, some people go for, like, 3 years before that happens, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Yeah, because I'm always thinking at the moment about JAR Media, like, what the fuck? Can we make a video that everyone likes?
Well, it took at least 2 years for my channel to get, like,
anywhere.
I mean, after 1 year, it was like, things were looking pretty decent.
Mm.
Yes.
I'm always thinking that after a year, it's like, yeah, that looks all right.
Yeah.
The best thing I can ever recommend to a smaller channel trying to start off is get behind a bigger YouTuber and try and get them to mention you in some way. That's the only way it'll work for us. And it sounds a kind of bit like shilling and like cock sucking and toe sucking and shit. Don't make it so you like you really need that fucking shout out.
Mm-hmm.
But you need a bigger YouTuber to support you because that's the only way anything is ever going to happen. And that's why.
What's particularly strange is the fact that we obviously have Alex on JAR Media, but it's like it doesn't really anymore. At least it doesn't do anything particularly for the views. It just doesn't seem. It's not like a lot of people showed up from his million sub channel.
I would argue against that. That point, Ruben,
because I think
Alex wasn't on the podcast to begin with, I believe.
Well, yeah,
don't
that's
take,
what I mean
don't
now,
take this as
that's
don't
what
take,
I mean.
Yeah.
That's what I said. I mean now it feels just like exactly the same constantly, and it's like okay.
But I mean, look at the Baited podcast. I mean, Keemstar has got how many fucking followers on Twitter? Like a ridiculous amount.
I think he has over a million. Right. Yeah.
I mean, the Baited podcast, the YouTube channel, doesn't have 100,000 subscribers yet. So. I think it just doesn't. Yeah. It will kickstart a channel, though. A big YouTuber
exactly,
being a part
of the initial 100 subs in one day thing, which was like huge for me at the time, was because I just happened to comment on Jello Apocalypse. I don't know if you know of him.
Yeah.
His video about Facebook or something, because I just made my video about Facebook.
Right.
And he just happened to come over and comment on mine, and he was like, this is the first time I've ever like commented on anyone else's video. And that was that initial surge of 100, which inspired me to, you know, go on with it, and then it went from there.
There's a lot of luck involved, isn't there?
Oh, yeah. But then it's not completely down to luck as well. Like,
you have to make something that's appealing. You have to have something that the people will like as well.
Yes.
Yeah, there has to be something for people to get.
Which is, that's my thing. I'm always thinking, like, what the f- does fucking anyone like the shit that's not the Jarcast part?
Right. I mean, yes.
Anyway, I'm talking about myself, because it's just something that's been on my mind lately.
You need to have good content at the end of the day to kickstart your channel.
It needs to be content of a certain quality in terms of like how it's made, but
yeah, yeah.
Whether to get that kickstart, I think it needs to be. It can't be shit to get the to get the kickstart.
Yeah, I guess
once you're fucking the ball is rolling, I think you can pretty much make any content you want, and people will still watch it. Look at fucking Markiplier with this video of a dog for 13 seconds. Like, how many views has it got? 1 million already. Like,
didn't
he can get away with fucking murder.
Eating cereal or some shit, or looking at a banana,
that's right.
I think it was.
Yeah, like looking at a banana for 2 minutes. Like, yeah. What?
Was that, he can get away with
that,
like just
random
XD something?
Humor thing?
Or oh, right. It's a random XD humor thing, I see.
Well, he's looking at a banana, like
oh,
it's
yeah,
the minion.
Banana, humor. Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
I just said those words, I feel dirty.
I know, me and Ruben talk a lot about how YouTube's in this place where you see a lot of the smaller content creators kind of focusing their content around
shitting.
Not saying it's good or bad, like talking about other YouTubers.
Yeah.
Yes.
I mean, how do you feel about all that? Do you think it's just a product of how it is, or?
It very much depends on the YouTuber in question, who's talking about it, and why you think they're talking about it.
Yeah.
I see a lot of these smaller commentators only talking about a specific YouTuber at that particular time because it's bandwagoning.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Look at Grade A Underrate, under the spotlight at the moment, talking about stuff that he was doing months and months ago when Keemstar was getting all this hate. The only reason they're talking about it now is because they feel they're safe to talk about it, but they didn't call out Grade A Underrate then, just now.
Oh,
and
yeah.
I'm literally seeing, because I was looking today, typing Grade A Underrate into the search engine, like there's a video being made every single day about an exposed video, in inverted commas, being made about Grade A Underrate. Just because he's the target at the moment, and tomorrow it'll be somebody else, and the day after that it'll be somebody else. You know, that's just the way it's fucking going. These smaller commentators, they really need not to pick the targets just because everyone else is picking these targets.
Yeah,
you know,
pick someone pick someone valid. Like you picked Basher, and it was like I don't know. I don't think people were particularly fucking bandwagon at the time. I don't know. It was months ago. I don't remember what was happening.
Oh, but no, it was certainly way, way after the event. Way after.
It was popular because of what you said or
exactly.
How you said it. Not
well, you
because
put the
it
research
was
in is what is the yeah, difference
that
I see.
Effort,
you're not just
yeah.
like...
Oh, what cunt. Right, guys?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But then at the same time, I'm conflicted because there is a place for that, you know? I don't want to write anything off. I don't know how to feel about any of this. But then at the same time, it's dominating everything.
Yeah.
None of us are... Jal Media's done it. I've done it. You know, you obviously do it.
But I feel like that's something we said about. I said about Jamita because I said I wanted to perhaps talk about how every channel, just or not every channel, these smaller channels are just fucking. I was talking about criticism. That was it. The way it's all, the only popular thing on YouTube at the moment is, oh, I'm going to fucking criticize this guy. I mean, whether it's good criticism or just like, what the fuck are you talking about? Criticism. It doesn't matter because people will still watch it. And I wanted to say about how, like, I don't like making anything particular like that. But Alex claims that we have done it. I don't exactly remember.
We definitely have. We've made videos talking about like the Leafy vs H3 thing. Like we were talking about that. I think that counts. Just using that as a way of.
But the difference
getting
is,
people to the
like,
video.
We actually wanted to talk about it. Whereas I won't. I won't just make myself talk
about. The only time it bothers me is when I'm watching a video about another YouTuber. Or someone who's talking about another YouTuber, and they're offering nothing new. They're not offering any insight at all. No opinion or anything. They're just saying what's happening, and they're not like a Keemstar
that. There you go. That's why I'll defend us a little bit. We do give an opinion on it, I think.
Yeah.
I think we probably did. It's an old video.
Like Alex said, a lot of these smaller commentator channels are literally just watching another video a commentator has made and just taking their points and just making a video out of it. Mm-hmm. That's literally all they're doing. Very fucking lazy. Now, I get it. The research side of things is the worst part. It's so boring. Like, imagine having to go through every single fucking FusiTube video, and I did on his main channel. I'm not
on his fucking
blog.
You went through
everyone. How many are there?
I had a feeling you might have done that, but fuck, man.
His main channel has about, I want to say 30 on his main channel, which doesn't sound too bad. And I did watch a few of his vlogs as well. Right. But like the vlogs, I mean, I can watch all of those because they're like an hour long and I'm not going to fucking watch every single one.
An hour.
And he makes one every day. Right.
And then did he have to like take notes and remember things? And
I took notes. Exactly that.
It's like the same reason like the Search for the Worst takes so long. It's because it's just research. It's noting down from like a 2 hours worth of content overall, and you have to somehow make a video of your own out of it.
Right, exactly. My process actually is to what I'll do is I'll watch the video first to see if there's anything good there, and then I'll download that video, put it into my editor, and then go to that specific part, cut it out. So what I'm left with by the end of it is just like this huge 8 hour fucking file in my editing software. With just like little sections with little quotes and things like that, and then I rearrange all those quotes. It's a whole mess. With the FusiTube video, I literally had 6 hours worth of individual quotes and sections and segments. It's like, oh yeah, that relates to that, that relates to that. And I made this kind of spiderweb diagram of like, well, that point's going to there, that's hypocrisy there, like that point cancels that point out. And it's like, that was a fucking mess. And I hated doing it because it was literally like being back at school. It was like a piece of fucking homework. And no, I did not enjoy the FusiTube video at all. To give an example, like, not the Bashiverse one, but there was the second video I did, which is just called Weed. I don't know why I titled it Weed, but it's literally just called Weed. I made that video actually in under 24 hours, and I did very, very little research for it. I was fortunate enough, there was this guy who had already kind of done, not the research, but he had these, like, best clips already made. So I just went to that video, and I was like, oh, those are good clips, I'll use those. But obviously, I'd known the guy for a while, but yeah. The research side of things is a shit to do. It's fucking awful. But it is important at the end of the day. If you're going to call someone out, you know, if you're going to expose someone, you got to do the fucking research.
That's the thing, though. I feel like some of these people are doing it just so they can get noticed by the person they're calling out, so then it can become a big drama thing, because that's how you get big on YouTube now.
I think that's definitely the case with people like Leafy. Yeah.
Yeah, well, because it gives you a constant stream of content to keep making.
Right.
And people love it. It is one of the most popular, you know, streams of content now, for sure.
Like, definitely.
once the Daddy Derek Cool Cat thing happened to me, it exploded the channel. And it makes sense, I suppose, for someone like Leafy to keep doing it if it's working like that. But then I suppose at the same time, you're going to lose some integrity or quality, you know, for your videos there.
So that's here's the question. Sorry, Ruben. You go ahead.
My point will change the point, so carry on and finish this.
All right. So. What I was going to say was, because this applies to, I guess, Alex and myself, does quality make that much of a difference? Because obviously,
no.
Alex and I
this is something I've always said to Alex. Yeah. I've always said when I watch him fucking spend as long as he does is, you know, you could just fucking do this and it would get the same views and everything would be the same for you. The video would just be a bit worse. But I suppose that's not the way it should be when you're making it. Because Alex spends a lot of time editing little bits. And was, you know, you could just like not do that. You could just save yourself time. And you wouldn't be as happy with your product, though. You wouldn't be as happy with it. And so ultimately, not worth it. But, you know, it still remains. The fact remains you could do it.
I'm beginning to see it a bit like a chocolate cake, right? You've got a chocolate cake. It just, the editing is the box it comes in. The wrapping, if you like. Does it matter what box it comes in? Doesn't matter how it looks, how it's presented at the end of the day. It's still a fucking chocolate cake, right? And that's the way I'm beginning to see things. Does the editing make it better? Is it the cherry on top? Yes, but that's it. It's just the cherry on top. You don't need to spend that much time on editing. And I don't think it's worth it at the end of the day.
It's a balance. Like,
it's a balance, yeah.
How long did the FusiTube video take? It was months.
Well, here's the thing. People are saying, oh, it took you 2 months to make this video.
Well, obviously, we weren't working on it full-time constantly.
Right. I have a job on the other side as well. And it's like, yeah. But let's say if I can give an approximate amount of hours, I want to say 180 hours on this on this video. Yeah. 180.
And that's obviously a way, it's not feasible. It's not, you can't turn that into anything when it's that, if that was all you ever did, it took 5 months each time to release a video. It's just not sustainable. You're not going to grow. It doesn't make sense for the platform of YouTube. You've known that. Well, you've noticed that obviously because I saw you tweet about you're going to try doing, you know, two uploads a week or something, which would be interesting to see if you live up to that or not.
Well, you've got colossally lazy now, haven't you? So
I have. I mean, I've
you
had
can always
that
work
for
with
while.
That a bit. Well, you can always work with it now a bit. Guess
I mean,
stuff
I
out.
Had this. I had this thought that I was going to keep Colossalus Crazy, like best video I can make on that channel, and then Colossalus Lazy, I can just do some, you know, random shit on that I don't really care about, and like people like it, great. If they don't, fuck off. But I'm beginning to think now that I'm going to leave Colossalus Lazy for like real shit. But actually just reduce the quality somewhat on my main channel. I think it's just not feasible to work
and
2-3 months on a video.
You shouldn't feel so guilty for it. It's not like, I mean, look at some of the fucking, okay, I'll compare YouTube to, say, I don't know, film industry. Yes, there are some fucking shit films made, but they have teams of people making fucking shit films. You're one person making a whole, like the Fousey Tube video was 45 minutes long or 48 minutes long.
Yeah.
That's like half a film in length. Obviously, it's different.
That is
officially
a documentary. It's 40
minutes.
We'll call it
a documentary kind of genre.
Part fucking one.
Exactly, yeah. So you have effectively made a full-length documentary.
As one person. Mm. So, you know, I think you're well within your rights to reduce your quality a bit if you feel that's necessary.
But then at the same time, I expect you agree, Clown. Like, do you feel proud? You like feeling proud with the videos you bring out?
Here's the thing. I feel proud of the end result.
Yeah.
Like, that video's out there. Like, I'm proud of that video. Am I proud of myself for spending that fucking long on it? No, I'm not.
No, that is. It comes down to the balance thing. You don't want to spend too long. But I think if I could make one really stellar video a week instead of two mediocre ones, I'd personally, just with me, even if it means less money or whatever, I would do the one. Just because that's just how my mind works. I like being happy with the result.
Definitely. It's definitely a big... I don't want to use the word ego, but it's a pride thing. Let's face it.
Oh, for sure,
it.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, as if you're as artists and creators, you want to feel fucking proud of your end result.
It is the pride. If you feel no pride, I don't see the point of
Because
well,
gradually it'll just wear you down anyway, and you won't want to make your stuff anymore, and then you'll make nothing. Right. Or what you do make will just be fucking terrible.
You want to make something that
you're
proud of.
Terrible about.
Absolutely.
That's why when the argument comes up a lot, a good comment that people like to say is like, if you're criticizing someone, for example, this person has this many million subs compared to you. That means they're better or whatever.
Mm.
And
I don't mean that at all.
It doesn't mean anything. It doesn't mean anything like that.
No, absolutely not. I mean... This is the quality versus quantity argument. What does the algorithm favor? We all know quantity over quality. There are very few examples of channels which have really high quality, very infrequent uploads who are doing well at the moment. Very few.
Yeah. Yeah, it's I feel like I'm in a lucky position myself, like
you are.
With what I can do with that. But I've taken that upon myself. I could have upped myself to two videos a week just for the sake of, you know,
some cash,
some extra cash or whatever.
Absolutely, yeah.
But I don't want to do that.
Well, if that's compromising your integrity then for the sake of some money that you don't strictly speaking
need. But then it's not even integrity that anyone would notice, I don't think.
Well, yeah.
No one would care. It's for me.
It's for you. It's your own. Well, that's what integrity comes down to, really. It's yourself and how you feel.
Mm. Then you do care what other people think of you, though. Too.
Well, if you don't care in that regard, then really
you don't really care
about
what commenters think about you. You care what other YouTubers think about you.
Yeah,
right.
I think,
and I think you and I, Alex, both care way too much what people think of the content. Way
Definitely.
Too much.
Yeah, way too much. Yeah. Yes.
See, it's strange for me because I've never made a strictly speaking good video in my life. So I just kind of have to. Like, yeah, too right, guys. Stick it to the man.
That's the thing. That's the thing. And like, that sounds like we're tooting our own fucking horn here. But like, I guess for me and Alex, we're like, we've built up this fucking level. There's no way to say this. That sounded like a fucking narcissist.
I know exactly what you're gonna say.
So we've built up this fucking level, this impression with our audience or whatever, and this what people think of our content and stuff. It's like,
an expectation.
Content. An expect, that's the word I'm looking for. So if we reduce it, we're like, well, now he's doing shit. Or is this shit? He's like, he sold out, mate. All that shit.
Yeah.
This is what has happened with H3H3.
Yeah,
H3H3 gets bad rep here. Because, yes, has his content reduced somewhat in quality? Absolutely. 100%. No argument there. Is it fair for people to call his content shit now? No, because I still think the content is good. It's not what it was. It's not as good as it was.
He's still funny himself as an entertainer.
Different. And people don't like different. People on the internet do not like different. That's it's the thing you have to come down to. I thought that Ethan and Ela channels being separate was a good decision because that eliminated that whole problem.
Yeah, I really don't think their decision to merge was a very good one. Really don't.
See, I thought they were onto something by having like their main channel really high quality and then their second channel just we can do whatever we fucking want here because they get the best with both worlds. I thought it was a great idea.
They get shit from people for it. Now they just get shit from people because it's like they see every video that goes on H3 as being of the quality of what used to only be on H3. But it's, no, this is like extra. If you imagine it, once every 5 videos, there'll be a video like there was on old H3 or the way things used to be, okay?
Yeah.
But they don't see it that way. They expect every single upload on it, every single one, to be, oh, we're going to do something that takes loads of time, loads of research, and lots of planning. Every day. Every day without fail. Yep, that's definitely how it's going to work.
I still think his content is good. Like, I will watch H3H3 and still like it. But is it as good as it was? No, it's not. Like, he has dropped the quality somewhat. It's still entertaining at the end of the day, so does it really matter?
But have you noticed that he's also at the point where I think they've realized that they can upload anything and they'll get the views.
Yeah.
They'll get the fucking views.
You mean, we can't... That's the only thing. I don't like just letting people off completely. Mm-hmm. Actually, wait a second. I was just saying then about they expect every upload to be this one thing. It's like, well, we're looking at like 2 videos a week. That's how they do it.
Mm-hmm.
And looking at it, it kind of just looks like, I don't know, it's weird. It's weird.
I can't comment yet. I can't remember.
No,
I
think it's like 2 a week, it looks like.
Right, well, that's absolutely fine. I mean, that's not even low quality, really, is it?
It's not even egregious at all.
No.
I think this it's just like, because when you title something like Harambe or whatever, that's going to be an easy target.
I think I was watching iDubbbz's video with H3H3. No, actually, it was on H3H3's channel, but it was like a collaboration with iDubbbz.
Yeah, it was like a YouTube blog. That was
and,
a good video.
And iDubbbz like criticized H3H3 in that video for the little Harambe video. Yeah. It was like, I think H3H3 knows that video is shit, right? He knows it's shit. And it was shit. It was a fucking dreadful video. But look, I don't think we can expect every single video to be solid fucking gold at this point. Like we're gonna make shit one way or another.
Do you think YouTube is like stagnant?
In what way?
In the way what we've just been talking about, where all the new content is
is just a clone of something else.
Yeah, but there's nothing wrong with clones because there isn't originality, you know, per se, because it just can't happen. You can't have, like, Stranger Things being made by YouTubers to that, like, level. It needs to be sustainable to the platform, but it's just, like, that lack of creativity. I don't know.
I think I would say things seem quite stagnant. I'm quite uninspired by a lot of what I see in my sub box. No offense, Aichi. Fucking shit.
I haven't uploaded in like 2 weeks.
I think it is true. I haven't seen like a video where it's like that's very original. I've never seen anyone do that before. Like it's rare when that happens.
It does, it's a viral video. Mm-hmm. They're not making a channel off it. It's like one viral video. It's not sustainable.
And
with iDubbbz, and I will probably say, you know, iDubbbz is my favorite content creator. In a way, because, he's the videos, every single video I watch that he releases, and I think he's an entertaining guy, whatever, but I don't think his content is, like, purely original, like, it's very much over and over again the same thing, unboxing, you know, Kickstarter crap, I mean, it's kind of the same
thing
each time.
It's him, it's what he injects to it, that's right, what it is now, it's the personalities injecting stuff into it, but then people... Yeah. seem to get a little too tied up in not injecting their own personalities into things and just doing, like we said, just doing the sort of clones, just doing the same stuff, and they get wrapped up in that.
I don't have a problem with the type of video, say, as an example, the bad unboxing thing as an idea, right? It's a repetitive in nature idea because it needs to be a series, something you can continuously make. Mm. But in the video, he's creative, he's funny.
Yeah, every
he
time.
Does his own
every
stuff.
Time
he's
each one has a weird thing going on.
So, I mean, there's the point right there. I mean, does it matter? How easy is it to create something purely original every single time? I just don't. It's very hard to create something original because everything's been done before. Pretty much.
But people love characters. They like personalities.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And I don't know. I just don't see enough of the blend.
Mm-hmm. Here's a fucking YouTube channel. Filthy Frank. Yeah, that's. I'm sure we can.
I like Filthy Frank's content.
I like Filthy Frank's content a lot. I've watched him for like a really long time, actually.
Yeah,
we're going back.
I mean, he's an outlier again, though.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, I was just gonna say because he. I'm trying to think. I mean, he's kind of a. He's got a weird thing going on because I guess he's like the YouTube equivalent of a jackass on the one hand because he does some weird. They just subject themselves to some shit. But on the other hand, he has like a story. There is a weird. There's law. There is people refer to it as fucking Filthy Frank law. It's so strange.
He's created something.
He is quite. I mean, I'm not sure if you could call it original or whether you could. I just call it creative. I'm going to call it creative. It is creative.
Well, he is creative. Like he literally writes music, right?
Well, yeah.
Yes,
he does do that,
and he does that too.
Mm-hmm.
I heard he hates making it. That's what I heard. I don't believe it.
No, I think I've heard him actually say he likes making it. It's not his job though. He just likes doing it. When he makes a Filthy Frank video, it's because he wanted to, because he likes doing it.
Maybe he hates it because of the audience. Because
yeah,
of the
I imagine it's his audience. I mean, lots of it is shit. Yeah. Lots of his audience is just the fucking worst.
I mean, once your subscriber base goes above 100,000, it's hard to not at least hate a portion of your audience. Let's be real.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, absolutely. Like I will attest that a good. I don't know. I don't even know if I can put a percentage on it. But let's just say that a lot of them are fucking idiots. They're just morons.
Yeah. Well, they kind of, a lot of them like, and I'm not trying to be all like, whoa, so deep. They kind of miss the point. They miss some of the, they miss like the real joke that's going on in there. Like,
that's why the trick is you've got to hide it through.
They miss the actual satire part. And all they see is the like man hurting himself. Man throwing himself at people.
That's what you got to do. You've got to combine it. You would combine it with something else.
I was really annoyed that most people didn't get the pig on the head joke that I had in my FusaTube video, where I literally stuck a fucking pig on his head. Nobody got that fucking joke. Do you guys get that joke?
I haven't actually watched your video yet.
Oh, right.
Ruben, what the fuck?
Well, it's 45 minutes long, and then I've been at university and a lot of things, okay?
It's all right. I forgive you. It is a long video. But basically, the joke was, right, because obviously FusaTube is lying about buying his fucking parents a house. He has his mother call him out for it. So the whole joke is like his mother saying, you didn't buy us the fucking house. FusaTube is saying he did. And then it's just so ridiculous because obviously FusaTube did not buy his parents this house. Mm-hmm. Like that's the end of. So what I did with the joke was just like literally stick a pig on his bald fucking head and like argue the fact that there was a pig on his head. And people didn't get that joke. They were like, you just randomly stuck a pig on his head. No, it was a joke, like to prove a point. I was really annoyed people didn't get that because I thought it was a good joke. But anyways.
Do you even look at comments anymore though? Do you look at them?
I do. I'm obsessed with them. I honestly say, like, people are going to disagree with me. Comments on YouTube, the comments section is the best part about YouTube.
You reckon?
Because it's,
When I go in the comments, I get very depressed.
I even love the negative comments, the really bad ones, because they're just hilarious to me.
They are.
They're so funny. That's why I love, that's the best part of YouTube for me, definitely.
I dislike the comments very much, because whenever there's something negative being, like, said about me, it's usually... it gets quite personal. People can see my face, and it's like, all right, lads, chill out. Yeah, I have a human soul. All right,
yeah.
Don't need this.
I don't want to sound like a fucking hard man here, but I don't think I've ever read a comment which is like, oh, that got to me. Mm.
It gets to me is because it's like you would never say that to me face to face.
Oh,
not like the tough
not.
Guy thing. Yeah. I just mean that they wouldn't do it because people you're not like that. But seeing it on YouTube, it's like, hey, I can be a cunt.
Yeah,
hell yeah.
But to be fair, then, it's the same thing. I'd never call The Amazing Atheist a fat shit in real life. He'd fucking eat me, right? He's a big, big fucking guy. I never said to his face. Like, I'm not a pussy or anything, but I'm not an idiot. He's going to fucking deck the shit out of me.
Yeah, that's fair enough. So
I guess it's the kind of same thing. I think we get away with saying a lot of the things we say in our videos. We never.
But these
say
commenters,
in real life.
That's the thing. They don't put themselves out there in any way. That's
right.
That's. I mean, I'm pretty sure
it's just
about
a comment on a YouTube channel,
yeah.
Right?
So I shouldn't care though. On the same level, I shouldn't care. But sometimes I'm just like some. Like, you know, every so often it just gets to me. So I just don't go into the comments at all because it's just easier.
Mm. I have a way of defeating it. I've like figured out the amount of time it takes for the fucking idiots to swarm in. So yeah. I'll upload a video and I'll be in the comment section. I'll be replying to people, and then it will get to that point where I'm just like, I'm out. See ya.
Yeah.
Because you do get a lot of good comments. At first,
you do.
At
yeah.
least.
There are, yeah.
And it's so fucked though at the moment because the comment section, it's not like it used to be. Like if a big YouTuber commented on a video, it would be the top comment almost for certain. Mm. But like KSI commented on one of my videos the other week. And I only found out because someone tweeted me telling me that he did. Like, why is it like that? Why is that the way? It's so stupid.
I don't know. I don't even know how the comment section even works anymore. How does
it even
work?
I couldn't tell you. Yeah. It's fucked.
It's weird.
It's weird.
But yeah, I think if you are going to be like, because after a while you keep reading negative comment after negative comment, like maybe it's going to get to you after a while, and that can be very self-destructive. So I think when it gets to that point, you've got to switch them off. But honestly, like with comments for me, it's just like, I just find them hilarious. You know,
I just
think
actually,
you can literally say anything.
It's not the negative comments that get to me. It's the tepid ones. It's the ones that are like, you know, I really used to like your videos, but this one, like, I don't like it anymore.
You're really boring now.
And they don't offer anything.
Right. The important thing to remember is, like, these people don't know what they're talking about. I'm sorry. Maybe like, two or three of them out of the thousand
they
do. But
they don't know what they're talking about.
They don't know fuck all. So that's why I never listen to them. And, I mean, secret is out there, right? Like, subscribers come, oh, you should be doing this. You should do that. It's like, I never listen to you. I'm sorry. Like, some of you might have some good ideas, but most of them are complete shit. Mm. So I cannot listen to a single one of you. I'm sorry. Yeah. I'm just going to just do what I think
this is right to do. This is going to be quite... Actually, no, I just went into the comments a second on the latest podcast named Please Give Us Ringworm. I don't really know why Alex called it that. Anyway, just seen a comment from 5 days ago. That iDubbbz guy or whatever was funny, but honestly, he comes off as a prick to me. Maybe that's just his character or whatever, but I don't like it. Still pretty funny about video about Leafy, though. I don't really know why he's saying that. What did we talk about? Also, the fact that he just kind of was like, I don't like iDubbbz. Wow, I mean, real funny. And actually, maybe I do like iDubbbz. They just ended up at that within one comment.
It's like, I don't even think he fucking knows, does he?
Yeah. What was he trying to say with that? What was he going for?
I don't even think he knows. Nobody will know.
That's what I feel like. With the comments, like, they just go there, they just type something, they hit enter, and it's like...
Yeah.
They just walk away from it.
Do you remember a time when you weren't making YouTube content yourself, when you would comment on videos? What the mindset
yes.
was? What was the mindset? What were you like?
A troll.
Yeah,
I think.
Me too. Yeah. I used to troll the fucking IGN comment sections and shit. Yeah. Like, I was terrible.
I've never been a commenter, other than the one time I got top comment on an Ashens video. That was it. That was back when top comment meant something and was obvious.
I don't think I ever got top comment. I think most of mine were just marked as spam or something. They were doing pretty bad, to be
fair.
This
was something I wanted to move on to, though. So this was just something I was thinking about. Whenever, because you said about these people, they don't know what they're talking about. They suggest ideas and they're shit. And I was thinking about in the real world when I get it, like, oh, and when people ask me like sort of what I do, or if it comes up in conversation, oh, I make YouTube videos. I'm like, oh, we should do, maybe we should do this together. And I just think that was fucking terrible. Shut the fuck up. Don't speak to me again. And I just get real sick. I don't like to talk about
talking
it.
Talking to non-YouTube people outside of YouTube.
It's just like, they just don't get it. But my favorite thing is that all of a sudden, you know, you mentioned it, all of a sudden, every single one, they're all YouTubers as well. They know what they're doing. They absolutely know what, they just know, they know what the people want. They know how to make a video. They know what's funny. They know what fits your channel style. Yeah, like when I get, oh, we should make a FIFA video together. Obviously, I'm going to put a fucking FIFA video on Jar Media. Yep, that's right.
Makes sense.
I've gone to the point where I just lie. I lie to my family. I lie to my friends. I lie to strangers. I don't tell them the truth about what I do.
Does your family know you'd,
oh,
you make
YouTube? They know. They understand it because, you know, they're like my family and I've explained it to them or whatever. They still
see,
don't
I haven't told
it,
my
but...
parents yet. I haven't told them.
Yeah,
really?
My parents know that I do
my father's
it, but
a
70-year-old
man. I think I tell him I make YouTube videos. I think he's going to flip his shit. He's also, because I work for my father as well, so he's going to be like, is this what you're doing in your free time? Is this what you're doing while you should be working?
Just lie
like,
to
no,
him.
I'm not telling the bastard. No chance. My brothers know because I've got three younger brothers. So they all know I make YouTube videos and they all like them. So it's all great there. But no, I don't think I'll ever tell my parents. In fact, I'll tell my father over his grave. It's like, by the way, Dad, I make YouTube videos.
Right on his grave
to be furthering the family business.
Right, exactly.
YouTube videos.
Just write subscribe to Colossal is Crazy on his grave.
Right, yeah, that would work.
That's
good
true.
Advertisement.
Yeah. Take the Dolan Dark approach.
That was fucking dark,
it?
Alex.
Sorry.
Can you imagine it? At a funeral, you go up to speak. I mean, if someone paid me, I think I'd do it. I'd go to someone's funeral, like I knew them, go up there and just say, subscribe to YouTube channel. Just whatever, whoever I was told to say, I'd do it.
Yeah.
Ruin.
That's just proven to me that you don't listen to Jar Media. 100%. At one moment.
What?
I caught him red-handed, Ruben. We got him.
Why?
All right.
You just called me out for going too far on a joke.
Oh, got right. You. Well, I didn't call you out. I actually quite like the joke.
It was just very dark. Actually,
not,
so get fucked.
Called.
Get fucked, Alex, all right? You're trying to make a problem where there wasn't one.
I'm not making a problem.
Classic I Hate Everything. Classic I Hate Everything.
My,
it was a good fucking joke.
My exposed video is coming along nicely on Colossal.
I think I might just do an exposed on myself at this point.
Why?
I don't know, just for the joke about the fact, you know, make it very nice and...
We should
well,
always
I like to the exposed idea. I think that's a good idea.
Expose, you wanted to do it.
Expose.
It's ruined
expose,
now, it's in a podcast
YouTube
now.
Ruined. Yeah.
Shit. Oh, fuck.
Ruined.
I fucked
oh,
it.
That's a shame.
Never yeah, mind. Say though. Goodbye to that one.
You can't say any ideas you're thinking about on a podcast because someone else will do it.
No, they won't.
Yeah. Someone
well,
else
no
will
do
it for you and
they'll
do it really terribly and ruin the idea.
Oh, well, I mean... Got another one I'm going to do as well, but I'm not going to say that one
What's
either.
What's that one then?
No, Alex, don't. Okay, fine. I'm going to do a documentary on how I'm dealing with life after Jar. Now I'm away from home. Going to do this.
I didn't expect you to actually say it. You got to stop making all these promises all the time.
I'm going to do it.
You got to stop that too,
for ages.
Clown. You got to stop that too.
Oh yeah, I fucking do have to stop.
You
that.
Should just what you should do.
I've got
is
so
you should
many
not,
ideas.
You should not say anything about
but
your
I don't
content.
Do any of them.
You should not make a single promise about your content and then just release a video when it's done. It's out of the blue.
The trouble is, people keep asking.
I feel guilty because I feel like I need to be like, look, I
never
am doing YouTube a bit, all right, lads?
You
so
fuck
chill.
Yourself with the two uploads a week thing. You said two. You said two.
Yeah, when I read that,
I
was just
one.
Like,
I said one.
No, you won't.
Did you?
Yeah, no, I said one.
Okay,
definitely.
One. Even one, then. You fucked yourself.
No, I'm genuinely making a serious effort to do one a week. Definitely.
You are.
In fact,
when
even if
it
it's
start?
Shit, this is how committed I am. Even if it's shit, I'm going to upload it anyway.
Oh, how often
like,
have you done that?
It.
How often have you like completed a video and then just done nothing with it? Or maybe not completed
say,
a video, but like written one or...
I want to say twice. Well, I did it with the Keemstar video.
Of course.
I saw
I still
his
think you
video.
Should have uploaded that.
Yeah, I do too.
See, it was too... It was like... A complete mirror copy in many ways to iDubbbz video. Obviously,
but
it was different jokes and things.
Yeah, that's
but it
was
why like
people
the same points were so eerily similar. It's going to be like, there's no way nobody's going to see me as copying iDubbbz on this one. No way.
I think I don't know. It would have exploded your channel. It would have helped you in every way. It was
right.
I don't know.
And
I just feel like...
I know it would. Oh, absolutely, absolutely. Because there were very at that
I was looking
time
to
there
it.
Were
I was...
very few.
Yeah, I was really looking forward to the Colossal.
Yeah.
Is crazy.
You'll never see it now. It's just one of those things that faded into the ether, I guess.
Just like that episode of Baited that you didn't release.
Oh, well, in fairness, there have been four episodes
four?
Of that now. Yeah,
Jesus Christ.
Keemstar has sacked the other three.
You know, we've only had one Jarcast where we're just like, nah, starting again. That was shit.
Yeah.
That was only 10 minutes, so that's different. That's not completing an episode and then deciding it. We know during.
It was the best decision, I think, because we had just had that episode where we're literally screaming at each other about grade A under A, and it was almost another episode like that in many ways, in different ways, but the same, really.
Oh, right.
So I think it was a huge, huge mistake to have released that episode, and I think the episode we re-recorded was actually better than the one we originally did, so it all worked out.
I got that vibe from it. I liked that one a lot. With the contrast from the one, yeah, with the one before it was like just so
ridiculous. I think it's my favorite episode as well. Yeah,
yeah.
I think it's we're just a lot calmer. Like we definitely knew beforehand. Like we've got to approach this much calmer.
It felt like you'd all got it out of your system prior. You know, all the vitriol. That's what it felt like.
I think it was a much better podcast episode.
I certainly didn't have to turn it down as much.
Tell you what, don't call this the Jarcast. This episode, just call it. I hate everything and Costless Crazy Talk for an hour. Ruben just kind of listens.
Why don't I call it Fart Pussy
Breakfast
Gravestone?
Fart Pussy Gravestone Breakfast.
Yeah, yeah. I still don't believe you've ever listened to an entire Jarcast. I refuse to believe it.
I have. So I haven't. I'm not going to say I've listened to every single one because you know they're quite long. But I have definitely listened to a few, like in the background noise.
That is what we are, yep.
Yeah. Jamie's your brother, I take it.
Jamie is, yeah.
He is, I thought he
yeah,
was.
Yeah, he is. Yeah. And James is the other one.
James is our fucking idiot friend.
Yeah, I
that's exactly
that.
What he is.
That's what
he's our idiot friend.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The main thing,
it's a good show.
It's a good show. Nay, you're lying
like
through your teeth. I can
hear
it.
I like it.
You don't like it.
It doesn't mean it's good, though.
I can do less of the fart jokes and like the toilet humor, but other than that, it's great.
That's Alex. That's all Alex.
I don't know. It's like everyone has like their own like view of humor and like what they find funny. I'm just never gonna find toilet humor funny. That's just me.
That's Alex loves it. Alex fucking loves toilet humor.
I don't get that because like his videos are like doesn't reflect that type of humor. So I've never been able to understand that. Like, why do you find toilet humor funny?
I don't know. I like vulgarity. I really like just extreme vulgarity.
Like, there's like vulgarity, and then there's like
just
like
being not funny.
Poo jokes and like farts and shit like that.
Yeah, it's Alex
like,
loves a poo, a fart, a willy.
Where's an example of one of those jokes? Give me one.
Pussy diarrhea. Wow, cringe. There
that
you go.
That was a fan song.
Yeah, but it was all things that have been said on the Jarcast, pretty much all by you.
That's because
every single one. You remember the diarrhea, Alex? That was you just saying, "I have diarrhea" at the start of the video.
It's just not.
Pussy. The overuse of the word pussy was you.
I don't find it funny myself. I don't find the thing I'm saying funny. I like the reaction of everyone. That's what tickles me.
What's
the reaction?
The reaction is people like, "He's so fucking weird," and that kind of shit. That tickles me.
I don't think that's the reaction. I think it's kind of like, well, that's not funny. I think that's the reaction.
That was what about the episode where every time the word diarrhea was spoken, a fart sound effect played? That was funny, right?
I mean, I haven't seen that episode, but I'm not going to watch it now. But yeah,
he went through the whole hour of footage just putting in a noise at every single mention of the word diarrhea.
Just literally, just so sad. Like it's the saddest
it's
thing
genius.
I've ever heard. It's kind of not.
It's wonderful. That's the best episode that's ever been recorded. No, the best episode was the smoking episode. Sure.
No, my personal favorite is the one where you had the Markiplier going "hello" every like just whenever.
No,
that was
the
my
good thing
favorite
about
episode.
The bonus of it being a video podcast is you can fuck with the audience in two different ways, not just audio, with video too. There was the one where we just had these cigarettes and we didn't acknowledge it once. We were just smoking in one of the episodes. And that's the episode that has the most dislikes too.
Why?
I people are like, "Wow, can't believe you're smoking. That's unbelievable. You're just killing the body."
Fucking fake cigarettes.
That cannot be the comment. That cannot be.
I'm serious.
If I knew the episode that it was, I would tell you, but I don't actually, I mean, What fucking one do you think YouTube Changed has, maybe?
It is that one. It's the same episode. So I know I've decided what I'm going to call this then. It's going to be Shitty Pussy Fart Sound Effect.
Featuring Colossalus Crazy.
Featuring Colossalus Crazy.
What's the thing with the frog, by the way? The clay frog. What is that?
It's Alex's possession. He can tell it.
It's like something you made in pottery class, and it's like stuck with
I wish I was that talented. No, talented. I don't know. I couldn't tell you. I don't know.
You bought it once when you were on holiday in a shop, and you wanted to get your Jamie, I think, to buy it for you. He was like, no.
I was too embarrassed to buy it myself.
Yeah, you were too embarrassed to buy that stupid thing. So,
but
then
why did you want it?
Well, you're why does Alex do a lot of things?
You're telling me you see that in a shop and you don't want to buy it.
No, I don't think I'd buy it. No.
No.
Why not?
Somebody gave
you've
it
got
to
a
me
garden,
for free.
Right?
I'm like, oh, hell yeah.
But can you even explain what it is?
It's a garden ornament.
Yeah, but what is it? What, like, if it had to resemble a creature or something, like, if it had to resemble an animal.
I imagine
people
it having spider legs.
People, it's like the Botoxed face of Thomas the Tank Engine, isn't it? The Botoxed face of Thomas the Tank Engine.
That's a good way of describing it, yeah.
That whole, like, Facebook page that just existed for a while.
Yeah.
Just think about the mentality. Like, someone sat down in a workshop somewhere and was like, I'm gonna make this.
You know, they started people started buying them, so they started going out of stock in different places.
You can't buy them
anywhere
online anymore. They're out of stock everywhere.
Yeah, because of us. Because of Jarrah.
Really? That's quite amazing, actually, yeah.
Some of them are really bad as well, really low quality.
I'd love to sell them officially. I'd love to get the license for them.
When the Toby Turner thing went down and these allegations came up against him, Keemstar brought up all the fucking Toby Turner toys. It's like, this fucking genius. And then he started selling them for a killing. Like, you got to hand it to him. That is fucking genius. Like, I wish I'd thought of it.
Would you have really, you know, devoted the time, though?
I would have done that. I would have absolutely done that if I'd seen them in a shop. But I've never seen them in the real world.
It's kind of fucked, really, if you think about it. Like, either way, you're making, you know, money off someone potentially getting raped or someone being convicted of raping someone.
That is fucked.
But even so, it's still fucking genius, and I wish I'd thought of it.
Classic Keemstar.
He just doesn't care. It doesn't matter as long as the green's coming in.
He doesn't think of life like that. You know, he's a different person, really. He's special. He's very special. Yeah.
Okay, moving on from the fart.
Let's answer some of the questions that we got.
Yeah,
shit as they are.
Touched on that.
Shit as they are, yeah.
Yeah, just do it.
A kind old wall's got a good one.
I was asked two really bad ones, if you want to just get past two really bad ones. Okay.
Yeah, go for it.
Okay,
so sorry, I'm just walking down the stairs, but if that's the noise you hear in the background. I'm not taking this too seriously.
Okay, from my Discord server, they're very funny, very original.
No, they're the worst. I hate the Discord server.
Yeah, they're fucking shit. Why the fuck are you friends with Leafy? And I responded with, I don't know if he is strictly, so I'm not going to ask him that. But I have now.
Content versus
why am I friends with Leafy? Like, why are you friends with anyone? Because you get on with them. It's pretty much the answer to that.
And the other one was, one of them wanted to know if you're gay. Which, of course, you can just reject that. Don't answer it. It doesn't matter.
I can. I'm not. I'm straight.
I thought you were a lesbian.
That's the answer.
Russell.
I am not. I am fully straight.
I thought you were an AI, to be honest. You're not even like a human.
I don't get any e-girls targeting me, but... I am straight.
So could you,
if you do want to target
confirm,
me,
could you confirm that you've got pussy on the brain?
No,
that's
because
true.
I'm too old now. I'm just old.
No, just please say it.
Have I got pussy on the brain?
Just say it. I've got pussy on the brain. That's true.
I've got pussy on the brain. That's true.
Thank you.
I gotta just no, my bucket.
I don't know why that's so funny, but
I find it funny that Alex is so happy with that.
Why?
Because Alex is a fucking idiot.
Right.
What was the other question? That was both of them, wasn't it? And so you're a lesbian, whatever. Let's move on.
Yeah, I mean, that's
kind of a war.
We did have one serious one, but we don't need to.
Was it bad?
No, it was like, at one point does taking the piss out of YouTuber turn into bullying slash harassment? And that's, when it's bandwagoning. You know, the answer is obvious.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Unless someone had extended thoughts from Colossal, but, you know, maybe we should answer other questions that are more unique.
Yeah.
Well, I can answer that one very, very easily. Like,
yeah, by all means.
Mob mentality is like, the thing is with, like, we've had this discussion before on the Baited podcast, like, if you make a video on someone, it's one person against one. Mob mentality is when, you know, everyone goes to that channel and sends them hate. I mean, there's a big difference, I think. I'm not saying, like,
actually,
I should do it and you shouldn't.
That was the first episode, wasn't it? I've heard you talk about it. That was episode one.
I believe it was the first episode,
yeah.
And that's the difference, really.
Mm-hmm.
You're not going to stick to some kind of schedule on Baited, so I'm completely just...
There's no schedule or anything.
There's no.
No.
I just want to listen to one every week. I want a day.
I think we are going to try and do it like once a week, last the goal, like just a random day once
every
week.
Sorry for interrupting and tangent, but...
Oh, that's fine. It's kind of like very much dependent on Keemstar, really, because he's like, right, we need to film this podcast now. And I'm like, no, can we leave it for like tomorrow? And he's like, no, Clown, we need to film this now. It's like, okay, give me 2 hours. Like, no, Clown, we need to film this now. So like, basically me and Tommy just have to drop everything the fuck we're fucking doing at the time and just do the podcast at whatever Keemstar whims, you know, his fucking the time, his schedule. He's a bastard, really. But in any case, he starts getting mad at me for like being late to the podcast. It was like, I'm driving back from work, just like, give me a chance here. And he's like, no, just got to film it now. And then we have a go at each other for like 5 minutes. And then, hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Baited Podcast. And I'm your host. Like that shit. That's basically every single episode. That's how it starts off. Keemstar in a bad mood, pretty much. Really? Just keep him waiting, keep him late, and then guaranteed Keemstar is a bad mood, and that makes the podcast. So it works out. That's the answer. Next question.
Yeah. Tyndale War. I've said his name like 4 times now. We've been talking a lot about negative things, okay? Gravestones, fart jokes.
Yeah.
But, Tyndale War here. Aidan Walker. Everyone shits on YouTube. Can you name any positive proponents of YouTube as a platform?
I think as long as every person who makes good content is benefiting YouTube in their way, I think is the answer to that.
Right.
Is there a really positive video out there on YouTube which has inspired people to better their life and shit? I want to say yes, but the answer Fousey is no, tube. Because it's Fousey. Hidden behind a fucking alternate agenda.
It's Fousey's videos. That's what they're for. Right. They inspire the masses to go out there, tattoo on their hairline, wear obnoxious hats.
No, I think that, and, there are positives, you know, to YouTube without it being like a positive video, you right. know. I don't know.
I think if the content is great, it entertains people, and then I think that benefits YouTube.
The reason we're so harsh on it is because we all really like it, obviously. We think it's a great platform. We just want it to be better, and it can do better. We know it could be better.
Yes.
That's the only reason we shit on it so much. If we wouldn't shit on it if it wasn't fucking up so much.
And that's where I believe commentary channels are good for YouTube. A lot of people say they're just bullying channels and they're bad for YouTube. No, I think you have to call out the shit stuff so the shit stuff gets removed or gets better. And it's just that way that there's more good stuff. If you don't call out the bad stuff, then it's just going to, people are just going to do more of it and there's going to be more bad stuff.
Do you think there's like
it's
a big pressure now?
It's a very simplistic answer.
Just so long as the commentary
really
channels
don't
turn evil, you know, and stop
me
in the bad stuff.
I think the results show, sorry, Ruben, I think the results show that it hasn't really changed that much because people are still making shit content.
Yeah,
so not really.
Definitely.
But if it does to a certain extent, then I say, fuck yeah, absolutely, that's great. Because if people are on their toes all the time, I've got to make better content, I can't get away with making shit, then I think I'm all for it. Absolutely.
And that's fair enough.
I'm slurring my words at this point. What time is it? Like 9:30.
Is it Betty Boys for the
Christmas? It is. I was up at 4 a.m. to be fair.
Right,
but
okay. Why were you up at 4 a.m?
I don't know. I just kind of woke up. I had to mow the lawn. That was my excuse.
You had to mow the lawn.
Yeah,
so
4 a.m.
You're that
it's a big
person.
Lawn.
You're that person who wakes up all the neighbours at 4 a.m. mowing the lawn.
I didn't start mowing the lawn at 4 a.m. Shower takes like an hour.
In a gated community, and it's just him, you know, so he doesn't wake up any of his neighbours.
You might wake up your ducks, though. Your Dolan darts.
No, they've fucking flown away now. I kind of miss them, to be honest, but, like, they're gone.
So, basically, he just lives in a fucking castle, is what we've learned.
It's in fairness to me, it's not a house. I mean, it's not a mansion.
It's a castle. Yeah.
No, sorry, what was I going to say? I really am slurring my words. It is a mansion, right? But it's not my mansion. My father owns it, and I'm just kind of living in it for a bit because I'm trying to help him sell it. So that's why.
How does you living in it help him sell it?
Because I like meet the buyers and shit, and like clean the house when they want to come round and like do that.
And use the shower and the and the
basically
toilet.
It's just free rent for me. And in the meantime, I get to live in a big house on my own. So
I live in a 6x6 room with a bed.
Right, university.
And a desk.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, you know. I don't have any ducks either. Quite sad about that. Could we do some company sometimes?
I loved living in halls when I was at university. That was great fun.
I mean, you know, it's all right.
I didn't do any work, but it was great fun.
Yeah, I'm kind of getting that vibe from myself already. Like, you're not going to do any of your university work, Ruben, and I know it. I can just feel it. So, you know, in
three years
time,
I've only got like
one
or two more questions here.
Yeah.
We got to let the old man get to bed, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Do you fall asleep to, you know, some people listen to rain sound effects or white noise as they go to sleep. Do you listen to, like an hour-long fart sound compilation thing?
No, that's listen to audiobooks, though. I listen to a lot of audiobooks.
Nerd. We've got a nerd on the cast.
I fucking love audiobooks. Alex. Like, that's Alex. What I really want to do, like, read out audiobooks. Oh, shit, I've just dropped my lighter.
You want to read out audiobooks? That's a good idea.
Oh, lighter. Oh, no. The clown. Oh,
no, smoke. No. The clown. You don't smoke, do you?
The clown smokes. Oh,
that's confirmed dislikes.
Ah. Oh.
You've just fucked our video.
Judging from your last video.
I'm going to get my lighter out of my drawer and drop it. Wait, hang on. Wait.
Yeah, me too.
Oh,
me too,
fuck,
guys.
Dude.
Let me do that too.
Fuck the video now. Like, that's 5,000 dislikes right now.
Shit.
No, it's an hour in. No one
there
is here
you
at this
smoke.
Point, I have a question.
Yeah, what
I have
was
a
saying?
Question. I have a question. No, yeah. Actually, you go. You're saying something. I'm not an interrupter.
Oh, no. Audiobooks are great. That's what I listen to all the time. Yeah. We should really put like a sponsorship for Amazon here. Like, are they paying us anything? No, they're not. But shame. They should do. But yeah, I fucking love audiobooks. That's kind of what I want to do, like read some of that stuff out, like professionally.
Get told that actually when I do reading in English language, like what? English literature, sorry. Why don't you, why don't you just do audiobooks, Ruben? Because I'm 16 and I've got to get my A levels, but whatever.
It'd be a great thing to get into. Just sit at home, just like reading a book. Like, it's great.
Not
Good
sure
job.
If that's fair use though, is it? Reading a book.
Alex, what? Fuck what? Off, all right? This isn't
Chapter
your show.
One. Colossal
this isn't
is
your
crazy.
Show. All right, I'm ejecting you from the call. That's it.
No, listen. We're going to make up our own audiobook right now.
Oh, I hate it when Alex says no listen, because it means it's going to be a really stupid idea.
Chapter 1. Colossal is crazy, has diarrhea.
Oh, okay.
All the 5-year-olds who fucking watched our media are loving it, I
Colossal
promise you.
Colossal had just gone out to light a fag when suddenly his stomach started a rumbling. He knew that if he didn't finish this fag soon, he was going to have a real problem on his hands.
Chapter 2.
No, Alex, that's enough.
No. Where did the clown thing come from, clown? What's the clown thing all about?
Oh, yeah, what is that about?
That's from a 80s cartoon that I really like called My Brave Little Toaster, which is a really good cartoon. You should watch it. And I just remember this one clown part, which is just... pretty scary as a, for a cartoon anyways, and I was terrified as a kid, and anyways it stuck with me, so I ended up using the clown pretty much.
Maybe I'll make mine the bear or the bear from the Teletubbies Bear and the Lion
taken
thing.
Zaptai's already got that one, Ruben.
No, but it's the scary bear, specific face.
Taken.
No, it doesn't count.
No,
doesn't
you're,
count.
Okay, fine, you want to deal with the comments saying you're a Zaptai copy?
Oh, fuck off. I was shit. I can't even say that I was doing this before he was born. He's older than me. Fuck.
You should just take the toaster. Take the toaster from My Brave Little Toaster. No one's got that at the moment.
I'm googling it right now.
It's a good picture to use.
My Brave Little Toaster. There's the clown.
It's a good picture.
There it is. What the fuck?
Yeah.
That is so weird. Maybe I will be the toaster, the winking toaster.
Yeah, it's good.
Have you ever thought about putting smooth jazz in the background of the Beethoven podcast?
While Keemstar is screaming. No, I don't think it'll work somehow.
Yeah. Okay, how about heavy metal when he's screaming? I just feel like you should put more sound effects in.
Like farts.
Yeah, of course.
Like a fart or a cat meowing, the window smashing sound effects.
You know,
good.
We did really well up to here, Alex, not just fucking shit posting
it's
it.
Kind of
the
like...
clown. And now look what we've done. This is your
kind of
fault.
Like transgressed into shit, really.
He brings it fucking out, and he does it, and then all of a sudden I start, and then we'll
be the part everyone loves, baby.
I think they'll really enjoy the bit where I ask you that very good those very good questions. The Discord server will love it; they'll really like it.
Okay, what's the Zubu thing? Yeah, what is that? Did you start this?
I thought you started that, Colossal.
It's, well, I think I probably have hung myself by now if I had started that. It's not good.
As someone that knows him.
Nothing I've done is good, all right?
It's just that Alex is a fucking idiot. for the most part. You know, he does stupid
concept,
shit.
The concept.
He doesn't
is
think
genius,
about what he's doing.
Right?
What? He there is does. No concept. How can you criticize the concept when there's no concept?
No, there is the concept is like you can literally create anything, right? It's just a random word and it'll catch on. Like that concept is genius and it's proven true. But why do you focus on that particular word of all things?
What would you prefer?
Just why?
Diarrhea? I
mean, like, anything. No,
you probably would have preferred
anything other than that.
Fuck,
what,
I know, I can't
what would
of
you have done in the same situation? What eloquent word would you have chosen?
What I would have done, right? And this is quite, well, it's not clever, but it's like, it works. I would have liked something to do with sheep because it's all about like sheep, like following that shit. So something to do with that.
I will save that and I'll use that in a few months when Zuby has run out of steam.
Zuby's going to run out of steam next week.
Zuby ran out of steam when I was editing the video, right?
Yeah.
Very good joke there, Alex. Really liked it.
Thank you.
Nice.
I'm an internet comedian and ranter, as they say. People take it so seriously, man. Fucking hell.
People take it all very seriously. You know, I strive to make content that's fucking trash and not serious
in the slightest.
I really do hope
the top comment is Diarrhea Zubu.
Now you've said it, Alex.
Yeah?
Yeah, it will happen.
Okay, let's all say what we think the top comment should be and let's see which one wins. Ruben, you suggest top
comment. Okay, well, it's going to go in order of who has the most subs, so mine won't win. I want mine to be cunt off, what? You cunt.
And... clown?
I'm going to go with Colossal is crazy sounds like the narrator from the Stanley Parable. That's the one I'm going to go with. I see this so much on my videos. Like, I get it. I do sound a bit like him, but
yeah, I've
just
thought about
it once.
Yeah. Who do you think is going to win?
You will, Alex.
If I win, both of you two have to retweet my tweet that just says Diarrhea Zubu.
I'm not agreeing to this. I'm not agreeing to that.
Well, Colossal's got Twitter pride, has he?
Well,
it's kind of weird, but I sort of kind of do, I think.
We've just learned that the clown's a big baby, a big pussy.
A big baby. Yeah. He's going to bed at only 20 to 10. Christ. I'm going to be up another 5 hours, probably.
Yeah. What kind of YouTuber are you?
Yeah, you're meant to be. Jesus every Christ. YouTuber stays up late at night. What are you doing?
I'm just a really, really lazy one, I think.
Colossal is lazy, after all. Yep.
Yeah.
What's your favorite horror movie? This is the last question, right?
Favorite horror movie?
Yeah. I don't know, like, anything you like. What you talk about is things you hate.
The only horror movie that I've ever seen that actually genuinely scared me, and you will laugh if you've seen it, is a movie called What Lies Beneath.
What Lies Beneath? I haven't heard of
it. I recognize the name.
It's with Nicole Kidman. And that movie genuinely scared the shit out of me.
You're scared of Nicole Kidman?
Yeah.
She is a bit scary, but it wasn't for that reason. Harrison Ford and Nicole Kidman, I believe.
I actually recognize
that. No, it wasn't Nicole
one.
Kidman. It was. It wasn't her. It was someone else. But it's got Harrison
Michelle
Ford.
Michelle Pfeiffer.
Michelle Pfeiffer. That's the one.
That's the movie that scared you.
Yeah, I don't know why, but it did.
That's your favorite horror movie.
Yeah, the one that was the most scary to me.
You think that's what it has to be your favorite horror movie? It doesn't just have to be a good movie.
I think if it does, it's got to do the genre has to do what it's set out to do.
What about
it's
like
a
Alien?
Horror movie, it's meant to scare you.
Oh, Alien.
What about Alien? Alien's not scary at all.
Is Alien a horror movie or is it a thriller? Good question.
It's also like science fiction though.
Right.
As well.
Science fiction,
loads of
thriller.
On IMDb it's listed as horror science fiction.
I wouldn't consider it a horror movie.
No, but when did it come out?
IMDb has spoken.
It came out in 79. And when it came out, that would have been scary. So,
did it really come out in 1979?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
It holds
Fuck
up
me.
Super well. I saw it not long ago. Like, it holds up a lot better than some of the movies that come out now.
I guess it would be considered a horror movie for that time, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. But, that's what I'm saying. But that still counts as a horror movie though, right? Surely.
I guess so, yeah.
Well, there you go. Alien wins. Defeats your stupid pick, but there's no one seen.
It's a good movie. I prefer the second one, to be honest.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Alien 2, Aliens, sorry.
Yeah,
Aliens,
can agree.
Yeah.
Do you
can
hate
agree.
Alien 3? Do you hate Alien Cubed?
I didn't hate it. It wasn't as good.
It's definitely not as good, but I actually quite like it. I'd recommend rewatching it if you really hate it. It's not bad at all. Fourth one, though, garbage.
I definitely don't hate it. Yeah.
That says a lot about you as a person. Aliens over Alien. I'm glad I asked that. From now on, Ruben, any guests we have, we're going to ask them that first. And then we're going to say, pussy
Alien
on the
or aliens. Yep, all right.
And then we'll know exactly where they stand.
I really liked, everyone hated this movie, but I really liked it. I can't remember the name now, but it was like...
Prometheus.
I love that movie.
I'm with you, man. I'm with you with Prometheus. Yeah, the story is like dumb, but...
I mean, the story is almost like a rehash of Aliens, pretty much.
Pretty much, yeah, actually.
But
just way more bombastic.
I still really loved it.
Yeah, like visually, it's pretty stunning. And it looks really amazing now, too. Like, it's not hot trash like people make it out to be. I feel like people just do that because of the critic thing of, anyway, the story is not consistent and the characters flip-flop all over the place and they forget about every other element that's actually quite quality. I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I agree.
Ruben agrees. I'm correct.
Talk amongst yourselves for a minute. I'm just going to use the bathroom.
Can't we just hear you do whatever you're doing?
No, you may not.
Come on, man.
Shame. Come on.
This is Jar Media. What the fuck? I thought you knew what you're signing up for with this.
Get your chubs out for the lads.
I didn't realize that an entire world would have to hear me pissing. No, this thing. I didn't realize that was going to be in the deal.
Isn't your cock just a huge hose? Are you scared?
No, because maybe. What do you think? That it's a possibility that when you hear someone pissing, that you can kind of work out the size of the genitalia.
I think it probably depends
on. Do you think there's like an equation?
Someone out there will know.
Well, no, it'll probably be the speed it's coming out at is one thing,
right?
And also like the amount that's coming out at one time, like this. Right. So I guess maybe the diameter of the of your urethra maybe would factor.
Just go piss.
Yeah, you should really go piss because this is wasting a lot of time.
Yeah.
Is he gone, Ruben? Is he gone?
I don't know, maybe.
Can I talk shit about him now?
Yeah, probably.
Wow. He's just copying my voice, isn't he?
What a prick. And you're just copying my voice.
We're all just copying each other. It's really indicative of the whole YouTube scenario.
Mm-hmm.
Should we do an impression of him while he's gone? Pissing away at his little Peter Dinklage.
I can't do an impression of him. It's too hard. Like, if I'd known before, I might have practiced one.
Go on,
right,
just
now.
Do it, Ruben, you baby.
No, fuck off. You can do it first.
Just say hello and welcome to the Beta Podcast.
No, because it would just sound like me doing a posh voice.
You doing a posh voice?
That's all it'll sound like, is me doing a posh voice. Yeah.
Was that really it?
No, that wasn't it. That was me agreeing with you, but in a posh voice.
Yes. Not a problem.
Fuck off.
Not a problem, Ruben.
Mercy doesn't pay the bills.
I was considering opening the podcast with me doing an impression of Colossal in the way that he intros Baited, but I decided against it.
Welcome to the Baited Podcast. Blah. Not gonna lie. Running out of things to say. Quite hungry, honestly.
No, listen.
What?
He takes a long time to do a piss.
Yeah, he's in a mansion, though. He probably hasn't even got to the bathroom yet.
He can't find it. He's lost. He's lost in his fucking mansion. He's wandered into the fucking house from The Shining.
Mm-hmm.
The little girls have captured him. He's on his tricycle. No one's seen his face, so he might be dressed up as a clown, like, just on the reg.
Might be just his thing.
On his off day.
I wonder what kind of clothing, you know, Colossal is crazy wears. What does he wear?
Very Bunce. When he gets back, I'm going to call him a Bunce boy.
Do you think he always wears chinos and like shirts tucked in?
I do actually.
You do? Do you look like everywhere you go, you're about to play golf?
Not quite that, but I wear very, you know, like, picture John Scarce, but without the checkered shirts and less fat.
Oh, right.
Oh, wait, hang on. I'm going to post a picture into the Skype chat and you can tell me what you think.
Okay.
All right.
We're all hanging on the edge of our seat. I'm falling out of my seat at the moment. I've slipped really far down in it. The mic is really low. My ass isn't even on the seat anymore. Quite uncomfortable. But if I move, I'll fall out of the chair. So.
Fuck me. I've got so many pictures of Fousey Tube on here. So fucking many. And then little girls on scooters for some reason. Like, what? That is pretty
weird.
That is quite strange.
There was a joke in my, I realized the other day, there's a joke in my FusiTube video about scooters or something. And anyways, I went on Google Images and I just
found like, the Shining joke,
50,
yeah.
50 pictures of people on scooters. And
why did you need a lot 50? Of girls here.
Well, not 50, that's a bit of an exaggeration, but like 20. I don't know why, I'm just trying to find the perfect picture.
What do you mean, the perfect that. Picture of what? What are you sending us right now?
I'm trying to find a picture of me, but it's kind of buried beneath FusiTube's fucking...
In amongst all the scooters.
You're just going to send a picture of FusiTube, let's be real. FusiTube with that clown makeup
on. FusiTube on a scooter. Ooh, I'm excited for this.
I reckon it's going to be an 8 out of 10 Bunce rating. What do you reckon? No.
That's me.
No, it's not.
That's you.
That is me, yeah.
I think I believe him. He's got a red nose. That's a clown thing.
No.
It is a bit red there.
I don't believe it.
Why don't you believe it?
You look like
it. You look David Bowie.
You well, either that or like a bit of a like you might kill me in the street. Yeah, you look like you might kill me in the street.
Are you trying to look aggressive?
Yeah,
I don't. Well, that's just my look. I'm not trying to look aggressive. I just kind of like look aggressive.
And you sound the way you sound, and you like I imagine you need to me. You're meant to look a bit softer than that. A bit softer around the edges.
No, I was imagining angular.
I was also expecting this to be a picture about of chinos. That's what I was expecting.
Oh, I was expecting it to be like an erect.
I don't think
I'm going to
see if I've got a full body shot here.
An erect cock. Classic Alex.
Why is that
Wait
classic?
A second. Now all of a sudden, your fucking Skype profile picture just makes more sense, you know?
Right.
Quite angular.
Okay, I understand. I can see it now. How many blazers do you own?
You're like Alex if he was
few,
like
quite
harder
yeah, that's what I wear. It's like sports jackets and shit.
Do you?
Yeah.
All the time.
So if I saw you walking down the street, how bunce would I think you were out of 10? In your opinion?
I think I've got to be a 10, right?
Probably, yes. Yeah, you're a 10 bunce.
As soon as that, as soon rating. As a single word flies out of that mouth, that's when the bunce rating just...
I bet at university you were mad. You were the one that drank the most. You had to shake the bunce thing. You were the bunce that drank the most.
I did drink far too much. Here's the thing now that I went teetotal after that for like... Well, teetotal is just for the idiot subscribers who don't know what that means. it means you don't drink at all. And I went teetotal for, I want to say, 5 years? 5 years without like... any alcohol whatsoever.
Wow. Sensible.
That was stupid.
Yeah.
Yeah, what are you, lame?
I've already had a beer tonight. I'm fucking mad.
Yeah, me too. We are cool in comparison to
We're
this.
We're very cool. You know, why this... we do... Alex, let's make our own Skype cool.
He's in a mansion right now.
Yeah.
You're in a mansion?
I spent like 2 minutes trying to find the fucking bathroom.
We did joke about that. We just got lost.
does it look like the house from The Shining?
No, because it's like really tall, but not wide. And it's kind of like, did you know with the Shining, the movie, the way the house is planned out is really clever. Like it's meant to simulate. Yeah. If you remember the maze scene at the end.
Yeah.
Like it's meant to be a kind of reflection of that, like lost in a maze. Like,
it's very
difficult to talk about, but if you like look up Shining House,
I know. Yeah. I know
on Google
mean.
And yeah.
It's visual storytelling.
Right. Exactly. It was really clever. Good movie.
Very good movie. What the fuck? What is this right now?
What is it? I mean, the podcast has ended, and now we're just having an extended conversation.
I don't think it's really a podcast, is it? At this point, it's more like.
I'm sure we just randomly
recorded a Skype chat.
I'm sure people will enjoy it. You know.
Yeah.
They'll love it, and I will get top comment confirmed, and I will get a couple of retweets out of you,
Honestly, might just stop the recording now. Call it the end of the podcast.
You're a tired old man. Goodbye and shit.
You got to say goodbye. Is that how you end your podcast? I like the way Keemstar's his. He's just like, right, that's the end. Bye.
That's just fucking it. Like, yeah. Don't give
that's
it.
How
just,
I like to do.
We're still fucking talking. We're still arguing. Like he'll just say, right, no, that's it. We're done. Keemstar needs to go for a cigarette. Like that's the end of it.
Wait, does he smoke?
Ugh.
Keemstar,
you know, I could do a cigarette, but I refuse to buy them because I know if I buy them, there's a good chance I'll get addicted. So I just take them from people for free when they give them to me.
And they're not a bunce boy, and they're expensive.
You'll never quit. You'll never fucking quit.
Exactly. Which is why I will never buy them myself, because that's when I failed. I know that.
Everyone's a smoker inside.
The lighter I have, though, I found on the floor of a club. It was brand new. I'm very happy with that.
I don't think the clown understands what that's like to pick up a lighter from the floor, man. He doesn't understand. He can't relate to you.
I picked up a £1 coin from a toilet bowl once.
Nice.
Really?
I'd probably do the same.
Yeah, that's one penny pinch, bunce boy.
I do the same.
I just wash my hands afterwards.
Yeah, you just wash your hands. It's nothing.
Right.
Have you seen one of those new £5 notes? What am I kidding? You deal in 50s only. Never mind. Ignore me.
I don't think I've ever owned a £50 note.
I have. Once.
I'm too scared to have one. Because if I lose it, I just lost 50 quid.
It went straight in the bank, but it was amazing. It's so big. Yeah. Are you one of the
penny pinching bunce boys?
If I see a penny on the street, I will pick it up, yeah.
Oh, there we go then.
Yeah, but I would too. So basically, I mean... What does it matter?
It's one more penny than you had before.
Yeah.
Wow.
There's new £5 notes.
Says it all.
Very nice.
Aliens,
very nice.
Penny off the floor. Says it all.
Yeah.
What are you talking about? just Alex.
It's like it's a penny profit, mate. This is the end.
We're done now.
No, this is the end. You don't stop in Sainsbury's. Sorry, Waitrose. In Waitrose, do you go to the deals aisle? The deal stuff, or do you just get whatever you want?
When it comes to food, it's like time must be a priority because I hate shopping. So it's just like I don't give a shit about the price at that point. Never look for the deals.
Confirmed, Bunce Boy, confirmed.
I don't care about the price of food anymore, though.
No.
I don't even have loads of expendable income. I just don't care anymore.
Well, you could have saved 50p on this product. Like, fuck me. Yeah, great. I could have also saved 20 minutes. Cheers, mate. It's like, I'm not spending that.
Time is money and money is time.
Yeah.
You know, I have to commend myself for this episode. Want to know why?
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 The amount of potty humor I have restrained just because you're on the show.
You've done well. I appreciate it.
Yeah,
one or
that
two
was quite good
out,
of you.
But it happened.
You know,
you've done very well.
Actually,
thank you.
While we're at it, you know, you may live in a mansion, but, you know, my university, literally a castle. Could live in it if I want as
really,
well.
Really? Which university are you at? Oh, yeah, that's a good university.
It's a fucking castle.
Yeah.
You're going to get sniped now, Ruben.
Yep, they're going to snipe me.
Bulletproof vest out.
It's going to happen right now.
On fucking the yogs. We're done. We're fucking
done.
This is the natural wind down, all right?
I'm stopping recording now.
You've got to end it, Ruben, properly.
Oh, thank you for joining us, everybody. I haven't been particularly vocal, but, you know, I just let the two rich boys talk about their rich boy things. Why are we rich?
No, I'm a man
of
people.
First of all, you live in a mansion.
It's not my mansion.
You live in it, okay? So get fucked.
If you were trying to seduce somebody, you would say it was yours.
Yeah, but that's different. That's different.
Not different. That means you're a bunce boy, confirmed.
I mean, I live in the top tier of accommodation at my university, so I've got that going for
Does
me.
Does that help with seducing?
I haven't seduced anyone. So, no.
You seduced me, Ruben. Climb inside
me. It's because you look about 12 years old, Ruben.
I don't look 12. I'm cultivating quite
young,
a nice
you do
goatee
look very
at
young
the
for
moment.
Age. Oh, have you got the goatee going on? All
yeah.
Right.
Hmm. Climb inside.
You don't
me.
Look that young. Fucking.
You do. You do look very young for your age.
You can't all look like angular David Bowies like you. Come on.
All right.
I've got a recent picture of me that I took for an NUS card. I don't look that young. Look.
You do look quite young.
You're a dick. I don't like you.
It's good. By the time you're 40, you'll look like.
Look at that. That's not that young.
You've got the kind of rosy cheeks, so it does make you
I know, that's because I just... My fucking skin is horrendously sensitive to everything. Yeah, really. Actually. For real. Quite a problem. Here we go. This should do it.
No, you're right. You don't look that young in this picture.
This one. I probably look younger in that one because my cheeks are fatter. That's still my pin tweet.
Yeah, no, you do look really... You look like a little kid wearing... Yeah. Who's drawn a mustache on him.
I'm saying as we're all posting pictures of ourselves.
Oh, no. That's not Alex.
No.
I'll expose you, Alex.
Who actually is that, then?
That's Golden Freddy.
Do you know what the story behind that is? I'll have to put it on the screen. I call him the Golden Freddy. But he's, you know, now and again you'll get adverts before a YouTube video.
Mm-hmm.
And they're like of some 50 sub channel that's just paid to get an advertisement.
Yeah.
It was one of those. You know, he was trying to sell me something.
For real, you two, brothers, all right? Just Alex is a bit softer.
I don't think he looks anything like that.
What, like the Golden Freddy?
Yeah.
Look, I'm going to fucking expose Alex right now.
Which one is it?
It's one I took.
Just picture what, you know what his, everyone knows what his brother looks like, so you just picture something that looks like that, really.
No, look at, there you go. You can work out by the process of elimination which one is Alex. It's nice high resolution, so don't be afraid to zoom in. Yeah, it's 6,000 by 4,000, unfortunately.
Right.
Is that when I was eating the ravioli?
The ravioli.
Mm.
Yeah. Give me the formuoli. Honestly, why have we not stopped the recording yet? I'm still going.
We're waiting for Colossal to tell a joke.
Oh.
I'm just out of fucking ideas at this point.
That's a good soundbite to have.
Yeah.
All right.
I'm clicking stop now. That's it. This is the end. All right. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for tuning in. Make sure you leave
time,
the top comment.
Next time, maybe Keemstar will get frustrated by this. I mean, he did say, I'm going to go on and be better than one when the clown song and dance. Words to that effect. It was something like that.
Yeah.
You know, maybe Keemstar. Can you fucking imagine
I don't Keemstar know what he would want to
on
say.
On the Jarcast. Yeah, what would he even...
Because when he went on Hot Wet Soup, he just kind of insulted them for like an hour.
Yeah, but he likes you and he doesn't know who I am. So, you know.
You should have him on.
Thanks for joining.
It would be funny.
Stopping the cast.
Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Diarrhea pussy.
I'm just out of fucking ideas at this point.
I'm just out of fucking ideas at this point.
Ideas at this point. Ideas at this point. Ideas at this point.